Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Today, I wish to take you on a journey like no other. From start to finish, I will take you through the life of an incredible individual. This individual has won achievements like no other and won accolades like no other. Some of these achievements include being inducted into the Hall of Fame and winning Sportsman of the Year. She's won every event that she has entered, beating the best in the world in England in 2012. She has made history by winning the most amount of races in a row. Yes, of course, I'm going to introduce you to the greatest racehorse that has stepped foot onto a racetrack. A horse that has not only captivated our nation, but the whole entire world. Her name is Black Caviar, and this is her journey, a journey like no other.
She was at the Melbourne Yearling Sales, what was that, 2008, 9? I don't know, time flies when you're having fun. But the reason I looked at her, she was closely related to Magnus, our former good sprinter, and as they say, love at first sight. She was a lovely filly, big strong filly, and I was very taken with her.
Lot 520. 520.
From day one, but yeah, I'd like to think that we had a bond, but there was a lot of other people working with her pretty harmoniously, like throughout her career, and I don't know if she'd even know if I was, she would even know if it was me or not. But, uncomplicated is probably the best way to describe it. She had great tactical gate speed. You could ride her to break them up through the middle stage of a race. She was uncomplicated.
Up now by Noski, she put four lengths on them. Demerit's running on okay, followed on the rails by Carrara, but she's just as impressive here at Caulfield. Black Caviar under a hole, won it by five lengths.
But Black Caviar took True Persuasion and dashed for the lead, going for seven straight, and the favourite went away by three lengths now. They're not making impression on her. Black Caviar well away from True Persuasion. Hot Danish is boxing on well, but it is all Black Caviar. Seven straight, she's cantered home by five lengths. And Black Caviar, the narrow leader. Schofield getting a little busy on Hey List. Star Witness peels over the heels of the mare. He's a big danger. Melito's putting in a run. Black Caviar still the leader. Malum hasn't really moved. Donna, she's two in front. Star Witness second. Hey List can't go on. Hortensia runs on. Black Caviar, though, holds Star Witness at bay. She's unbeaten 8 out of 8. What a champion she is. Black Caviar beat Star Witness by 3.5 lengths.
Riding a horse like Black Caviar got recognised a little bit more, but I'm a sort of a backseat sort of bloke, so I don't like the limelight too much. So yeah. that was the uncomfortable part of being an ambassador.
Three lengths on Crystal Lily. King Pulse beaded is coming home. Black Caviar away by four lengths with 150 metres to go. This is unprecedented. 10 straight. Black Caviar by four. Crystal Lily and beaded, but she is unparalleled. Black Caviar, perfect.
It's a testing track, Royal Ascot, but I felt that we'd done sufficiently to get away from them, and all I did the last bit was just let her coast to the line.
Yeah.
Because I was sort of agitating her a little bit, I suppose, because she didn't drag me up in the race like she usually does, and she didn't. But I thought we'd done enough, and to win the race, and I let it coast, and very, very nearly got caught, because she stopped under me, and we found out. Once the dust had settled that she'd injured herself during the race, so the one we got away with, and one I don't sort of reflect on too much.
There are length to Escalar, followed by Krypton Factor and Jimmy Stars and Restia D'Argent, and further back is Genki. But as they come up now onto the course proper, 2 furlongs left to go. Sol is the leader. Now Nolan starts to shake the reins at Black Caviar. She starts inside. She draws level now with a furlong left to go. Now he says go on the mare. She gets about a half length in front of Sol. Restia d'Argent, Moonlight Cloud coming home fast, but it's Black Caviar in front with 100 yards left to go. Here's Restia d'Argent and Moonlight Cloud. He eases up near the line. Here's Moonlight Cloud. It's tight. Black Caviar and Moonlight Cloud in a photo. In third, then Restia d'Argent, followed by Sol.
On the line on the inside, so I was positive she'd won, but the people around me suggested that she might have got beaten, so it was, I wanted to turn around and look at it, because I was sure she had won.
Rain Affair kicked away at the stop of the straight. Nolan asking the mare to come after him now, and in a heartbeat she raced up and hit the lead. She's giving Sydney some of the black magic, and look at her go, Black Caviar. She raced away. She's going to set a new Group 1 record in Australia. She's truly in a league of her own. Black Caviar racing away from Epaulette. Black Caviar doesn't let us down.
Not really, because I'd probably brace myself for it for a season, if not even more, previously. Yeah. So, no, it wasn't. You know, something I haven't been afraid to do in the past. You know, I retired Typhoon Tracy off the back of a Group 1 win, so I was well versed in it. So, no, it wasn't something that really worried me.
I was at driving home from Sandown. I was leaving here on the Tuesday morning when they announced it on the Wednesday.
Yeah.
And Peter, he went. He's feeling his name to me, and I fully endorsed him and supported him because she had nothing left to prove. And because she remained unbeaten, there was an air of invincibility about her. Mm. And we're only going to damage it. But she could have raced on another season. But it's good coaches and the good trainers that retire at their peak. And instead of going one season too long or one run too many, I think Peter, she's been wonderfully handled by Pete the whole way through her career, but I think that was to see again an example of his fine horsemanship was the fact he retired while she was at the top of the game. Yeah. So that was a wonderful thing, and then I got a chance to sort of take a deep breath and relax and not worry about the pressure anymore.
Is a blue.